Our Holy Father, Pope Francis, is calling us to be joyful witnesses of God's presence and power at work, especially in the most challenging places in our own country, and to walk in solidarity with all of our brothers and sisters. I recently spoke of this call with Father Greg Boyle, who has transformed the lives of thousands of gang members in Los Angeles, California, where he founded the gang intervention program, Homeboy Industries. Homeboy offers job training, counseling, tattoo removal, and other services. Similar programs experience a 30% success rate, while Father Greg's mix of compassion and kinship returns 70% of his homeboys and homegirls to good, productive lives that are faith-filled and family-centered.
Around here we say, if love is the answer, community is the context. But tenderness is the methodology. It's how people kind of work that stuff out. So, you know, a job is nice, but healing is forever. And so that's kind of the most enduring thing that people encounter here. The profile of any kid who ever joins a gang, of course, is a kid who's deeply stuck in a dark place, a lethal absence of hope. It's also a kid who's perhaps hugely damaged and traumatized, or it's a kid who's mentally ill. And no hopeful kid has ever joined a gang, ever. So that profile is still intact when they walk through our doors here. So our place is not for those who need help, it's only for those who want it. So they have to walk in the doors here, and it's a healing place of hope.
I first heard about homeboys in prison. You know, Father Greg, come to Father Greg, he'll get you a job. But I didn't know the extent of what Homeboys was about. So basically what Homeboys is doing is they're paying you to better yourself.
Right.
Because all these classes are tools to make you change the way you think.
Rudy's about to leave us, and Rudy is a good example of, after 18 months, he's come to those insights. Now the world will throw at him what it will, but he's not going to be toppled by it this time, because there's the strength of his own recovery.
I was addicted to drugs and alcohol, so I want to change that cycle for my children and not have them experience what I experienced growing up for me.
There isn't any gang member here who doesn't have multiple rivals. So people they used to shoot at are now people they bake bread with.
As you kind of look at the church in its mission, is there something you'd want to say to us in our work at Catholic Extension and working with very poor communities of people? Anything that you'd kind of see as things that you've experienced here that you really think are kind of universal things that the church ought to be doing today?
The poor have a particular access to the joy of living the gospel. And Pope Francis always talks about our credibility completely rests in that gospel on the margins, the gospel, you know, to folks at the edges of our society, that's where the gospel has to be lived. That's where the church needs to be.
If I were to ask you what the secret sauce or the secret ingredient of Homeboy is, what makes this such a powerful experience?
I would say kinship, community, and just hope, right? It says it, hope has an address, and this is it.
Rudy Martinez and Father Boyle are inspiring examples of Christ's love at work in a community of hope. Together they show us that faith and kinship transform everyone, people seeking a way out of hopelessness and poverty, and those of us who choose to walk the journey with them.